make these work lights now? With clips that hold them in place?
Yeah, I was gonna get one, but I decided to have you instead.
So, Dad, what's the deal? Now we can afford to live in a neighborhood where there's birds flying over us instead of helicopters. But we can't afford an auto mechanic?
That's what I'm saying. Why pay an auto mechanic when I can fix it myself? Your grandmother taught me, and I'm gonna teach you.
Grandma taught you?
The army taught her school.
So is Grandma moving in with us?
She's perfectly fine where she is.
Really? She says that place is like a prison.
That place is not a prison, all right? It's a senior's apartment complex. They got a game room, and she can trade personal items for cigarettes. Does that sound like a prison?
Well, it kind of does. You know, I wish this father and son moment could last forever. Oh, wait, it is.
You want to go inside?
That's what I was saying. Mom! Dad's so rich in my head, he could have killed me!
And yet, he didn't. He must really love you.
I'm looking for some sympathy here.
Yes, and I'm looking for someone who made his bed this morning. Life's full of disappointments.
So I'll go make the bed.
That's what I'm saying. And hurry it up, because after your dad storms in here to tell me what you did, we're all going to the mall to get you a suit for your big date with literally the girl next door.
It's not a date.
It is so a date.
Shut up. You shut up.
Hey, you two, how many times have I told you to say please?
You're taking Sarah to the junior cotillion. I thought girls were icky.
No, just you.
You're just jealous because we're at a new school and it's only been 6 months and I'm already popular and on the cheerleading squad and you're not.
Yeah, right. What an honor. Having boys toss you around and putting their hands all over your butt at every football game.
That is not the reason I am a cheerleader. Well, not the main one.
So it is the reason.
Can we get back to David and his girlfriend?
She's not my girlfriend.
Whatever.
We just thought it would be fun to go together and rank on all the losers who show up.
Sweetie, it's okay. I met your father when I was 15, fell in love, and never dated anyone else ever again.
Mom, seriously? You're the kind of people we were planning to make fun of.
You know they make these work lights now? With clips that hold them in place.
You know they have these things called apartments where you pay your own rent?
Oh, how's this? Can you see everything? So how long is it gonna take? I gotta go pick up Daniel. It's my weekend with him. And Connie gets pissed off if I'm late. Well, she also gets pissed off if I'm early. She also gets pissed off if I'm on time. Hey, Connie's just pissed, huh?
Must have figured that out the first time the police pulled her off of you, huh?
Hey, she's got me by, like, what, 100 pounds?
Oh.
You know what I think? I think that success is making you edgy, my man. Yeah, you know, that new promotion at the copper mine, the new house with no bars on the windows. You know, that little tie they make you wear at work. Hey, take it from me, bro. That's so the man will have something to grab while he strangles you.
You're a dog catcher.
It's called animal control.
Oh.
And actually, we've been having more squirrel problems now. But I don't want to talk about work. I want to leave that stuff in the van. Oh, hey, by the way, the city inspector came by yesterday. You know that wall you built in the back? It's a foot too short. Nice going, Bob Vila.
I didn't know you smoked, so I'm going to give you a 5-second head start.
Hey.
Run like I'm Connie. Run like I'm Connie.
I'm rich.
You know, of all the parts of my Mexican heritage that I'm most proud of, taking the extended family to the mall in one car to buy one item is probably my favorite.
Stay with your cousin, okay? Because Connie would kill me if I lose him again.
So you get your own room, Maria gets her own room. And when I come over, I get my own room. Maria, it looks like a castle or something.
Don't forget the magical refrigerator that makes ice cubes por sí solo.
Vaya, debe ser genial, señorita Blanco.
Sí, eso lo sé.
¿Estás aburrida, cariño?
A little bit.
Pero, papá, esto no debe ser mí. Debe ser por David.
¿Por qué no te vas? Probablemente necesitas zapatos. Ve a comprarlos.
¡Ay, gracias! Hasta luego, tonto.
Buena jugada.
Papá,
ya no se dijo que quiere un helado.
¿Quiero?
¡Quiero!
María, lleva a tu primo contigo.
Sí, María, lleva a tu primo contigo.
Interesante movimiento. Cuídate esta noche.
Mira, mijo. Este es genial. Terciopelo como los cuadros que teníamos.
O el rayón.
Igual que el sofá.
¿Qué cosa, abuela?
Es genial, sí. No tienes que llevarlo a la tintorería. Solo tienes que lijarlo y pintarlo. Te buscaré un traje real.
Nunca saliste con alguien más, ¿no?
No, because I knew. Even at 15, this man would be able to strike fear into the hearts of my children. Plus, when we started dating, he was a lot taller than me. A clown suit.
Nice raffle, Maggie.
Tienes buen gusto en la moda.
Bueno, en el ejército.
Es una buena historia, mamá. ¿No deberías volver a tu departamento?
No es un departamento. En un departamento no tienes que llamar a la recepción en las mañanas para que sepan que aún vives.
Tío Ernesto, ¿qué sucedió? Tú eres genial, la abuela es genial. ¿Qué le pasó a mi papá?
Tu papá es un chico bitle. ¿Eh? Es algo estirado. Los Beatles son un tanto perfectas. Y los Stones, ¿verdad? Parece que van a perder el control de lo que hacen, pero nunca lo pierden. Así como yo. Los chicos Stones.
If you ever want to take them off, play the Stones. Especially Keith Richards stuff.
But I'm trying to not take them off.
Okay. You're gonna miss out on a lot of fun. And during my counseling for my third marriage, I found out that's called passive-aggressive behavior. And you know what? It really works. Excuse me, can you point me to your underwear? Hey, that's a good pickup line, huh?
Yeah. I bet I could get into one of those Indian casinos with this. Where's Uncle Ernesto? Where's Mom? Where's anyone but you?
How about this new Bronson, huh?
Come on, Dad. I'm in a new school with new kids. You put me in there, and you might as well just beat me up yourself.
You want this one?
That's what I'm saying.
All right, I'll take care of it.
Wow. Thanks.
Well, hurry up, okay? We gotta get your grandmother in before lockdown, or we're stuck with her the whole night.
I like Grandma. What's the big deal if she stays over?
Imagine 20 years from now, I find out where you live and I want to move in with you.
Got it.
Stop that, all right?
What?
The humming, the singing, man. Stop it.
I'm sorry. I didn't know I was doing it.
What's happening?
Hey, what's up, guys? Hey.
Nice dig, boss man.
Hey, see, you found the refrigerator, huh?
Well, we could put them back if you want us to, but it was Rudy's idea to take them.
No, my idea was to take them back to the car.
Come on, guys, we're friends, man. Just because you work for me now doesn't mean that we can't spend some downtime together. Huh? Now, Manny, you're in Briggs. Rudy, hold the rebar.
It's not like it is in those beer commercials, huh?
Well, Episcopal is almost like Catholic, and their church is a lot closer to our house.
Okay, so, we'll drive the kids, and you'll pick them up, and, let's not forget, the more pictures we take, the more embarrassed they'll be later.
I am so glad you guys moved in. Oh, I almost forgot. We were thinking of getting some work done in our yard, and I saw those Mexicans building a wall for you. I hear they're really good. And those guys look trustworthy. Maybe I could get their number from you?
Sure. I know it by heart. Because they live with me. Because I'm married to one of them. The cute one.
Oh, my God, I am so sorry. I thought you were Spanish. Your daughter said you were all from Spain.
Yes, well, Maria's got a very active imagination. Plus, she lies like a Spaniard.
Yeah, well, of course she looks good in those pants. She throws up every day during fourth period. Mom!
Could you tell me this story just for my own? Because it's funny. About how it is that we're all from Spain.
Grandma, I'm gonna have to call you back.
See the suit. Okay. I just want you to know that it may be the coolest thing I've ever bought.
No way. Cooler than that underground video where that skater cracks his head open and then touches his own brain?
Wait till you see the shine on this shark skin. My God. He switched them.
No, no. It's great. Brown is the new puke green.
Nice.
Hey, David, I know what you're gonna say, man.
Nice hey. Talking to you.
Catch you later, sir.
He's getting so big.
The screens?
Oh, stop it!
And how do you know when you're done anyway?
Well, according to Dad, when I can see my reflection.
Okay, look. I am not very comfortable being nice to you, so I'm gonna say this very fast. Dad is always right. Nothing else matters.
But I do so much for him. I spend all those hours holding the flashlight. I let him take my tire swing and use it on the El Camino.
Dad is always right. Now, instead of fighting with him, you should try to convince him that the things you want were his ideas. You may have to live with the occasional brown suit, but in the long run, you will get exactly what you want.
And it really works?
Let me put it to you this way. I'm this close to getting him to convince me to get my belly button pierced.
But that's what you want.
Okay, obviously this is too much too soon. For now, just stick with Dad is always right.
Dad is always right.
Mm-hmm. And so am I.
I think we're having a pretty good week.
Pumpkin pie was really good.
Oh, don't thank me. Thank our racist neighbor, Karen. It was one of what I'm sure will be a huge collection of oh my God, what did I do gifts.
Hey, she bakes pies like that, she can fill me with candy and hit me with a stick.
Maria's been telling people she's from Spain.
Oh, that's so cute.
Oh, yeah, so cute. She's just lying about who she is and completely rejecting her heritage. Super cute.
You want me to pick her punishment? Because I'll have her hose down the gravel.
No, I want to think of something that she can actually learn from.
That's what I'm doing. It's a sense of hopelessness that teaches the valuable life lesson.
You're funny. Oh, and you lied to your son.
That happens. For your information, I didn't lie to our son. I just changed my mind.
Whatever you want to call it.
Baby, when I got to that counter, I just thought I can't let him do this to himself. I can't let him go to that dance dressed like Elton John's son. Which is something that doesn't exist, by the way. You get ahead in this life like I did. You work hard and you don't call attention to yourself.
Sweetheart, what David did was wrong, yes. But That doesn't change the fact he needs something to wear on Saturday.
Baby, I already got him something to wear, and he ruined it. So now he's just gonna have to wear whatever's in his closet.
You've worked so hard to give him a better life. Now let him enjoy it.
I don't want him to enjoy it. I want him to appreciate it.
Sweetheart, you're talking to me, not one of your kids. If you want to have an actual conversation with your son, ever, you might have to open yourself up to the possibility that you're not always right.
But that's all I've got. I can't believe they wouldn't let you into that formal dance without a suit. Tucson has changed, my friend.
I can't believe you switched the suits. And then I had to wear this. And then I was asked to valet park a bunch of cars while I was waiting for you out front. Sarah's never gonna speak to me again.
But if you would have parked some of those cars, you would have enough money to buy your own suit.
Only the brown one. Because it's such an ugly... Actually, you know what, Dan? You're right.
About what?
I don't know. That's as far as I got.
I just thought the brown suit was more practical.
Yeah, that.
It's conservative. And you never know when you might need it to go to a funeral or apply for a loan. Or wear an ugly suit. But that doesn't mean that you can throw a... I was wrong in switching the suit, David.
What?
I don't know. That's as far as I got, too.
This is weird.
Really weird. And don't worry about your girlfriend, dude.
She's not my girlfriend.
Right, okay. She's cute. Huh? Come on, I meant that she's cute and I'll drop the whole thing.
Seriously?
Yeah.
She's cute.
David's got a girl. David's got a girl. David's got a girl.
Hey.
Are you mad at me?
No. Actually, I think I saw just enough of the junior cotillion to know that I won't be needing to attend the regular one.
There's a regular one? Maybe I can almost take you to that one, too. I'm really sorry. It's just that lately, everything's been so screwed up. I just moved. I don't know anybody at school, and I don't know if you've noticed, but my best friend is a girl.
There are some advantages to having a girl for your best friend.
Wow. Was that to make me feel good? Or is that something you've been wanting to do for a while?
And this is so you'll stop talking about it.
I'm done talking.
Yes, you are.
Hey, Pepito! Want cooking? The neighbor lady brought him over. She also says she's a big fan of Edward James Olmos. He's a little too intense for me, but to each his own, right?
Hey, Uncle, can I ask you a question?
Sure.
About girls.
David, I got 3 ex-wives, bro. Believe me, there'll be plenty of time for us to talk about girls. And lawyers.
And something else. Tonight, on the way home, Dad actually said he was wrong.
Were there any witnesses?
No.
That's how he does it. don't worry. Here, check this out.
Tio, it's late.
That's Keith Richards singing the first verse.
Hit the garbage up!
The Stones never let you down.
Our top story tonight, Arafat under siege, the Palestinian leader's compound under heavy fire from Israeli troops. We're live with the latest.
And then a shooting scare at a local high school. See what happens when a gunman is spotted on campus. Plus, it's one wild pursuit. A truck owner hides in the bed of his pickup as a pair of thieves try to outrun police.
And tornadoes leave a community in virtual ruins. We'll show you the hardest hit area.